I'm Reverend Dave Johnson, and my job basically is a comic book cover artist. I wanted to be an illustrator for a while, and I actually went to school for that. And then somewhere along the lines, I decided that that was too hard. And comics, you know, I was always into comics growing up, and it was something like, it seemed more of a viable option that I could actually get work as a comic book artist, and I did, and the rest is history. Like everybody, you start practicing your craft, and hopefully you get good enough to where you put it in a portfolio or samples, and you send it off to Marvel or DC, and hope you get some bites. Me personally, I joined a studio with a bunch of other comic book artists and
a bunch of no names.
No. And guys like Brian Stelfreeze and Adam Hughes, and just having contacts with their contacts eventually led to some work. Yeah, when I was starting out inking my tools, I was using rapidographs to ink, and which have no give, no snap, no line variation, and it was by far one of the worst tools to use to ink, you know, anything organic. And then later I moved up to a Uniball, and I was using Uniballs, which is almost as bad. And then I started learning brush, markers started getting better, and they had more give. So I was using a combination of marker and brush. The materials definitely have changed. I mean, markers have gotten better. Brush markers have gotten incredibly, this one right here has made me a better artist, and this Japanese marker has made me a better artist. I mean, it gives me the kind of snap that the old guys had with quill and brush, which, you know, it's, you know, a little harder to pull off for me. So I don't really draw that much. I'm kind of lazy. I think about the drawing more in my head than I do laying it out. A lot of my stuff is very graphic design wise, so it actually looks better a lot of times the less I draw. So I pretty much stick to that more than anything right, you know, currently. I've got a Cintiq, use Photoshop, mainly to color, not necessarily to draw. I usually bring the drawings into Photoshop to color. So I use whatever needs to be done. You know, I mean, I'm not a super effects heavy guy, except my stuff is usually very graphic and simple, so you're not going to see a lot of lens flares and weird shit on there. So usually real simple stuff. Going back to inking, I feel like I've developed a style via me coming to Drink and Draw Social Club for the past 5 years, and I feel like my inking style is finally more mine than me being influenced by anybody else. Most of my career I feel like I've been chasing after, you know, trying to be like Mike Golden or, you know, whoever. And I've, you know, now when I sit down, I don't really think about how to do things as much as I just do them, and I like the result, you know. And like I said, it feels more like me than any other time in my art career. So things are good.
Yeah, I developed at Drink and Draw. I developed this jagged style. It's just so much fun to do, you know, and there's no wrong way to do it, I guess.